Good morning, my Dhamma brothers and Dhamma sisters. Today is 30th October 2030. Morning lecture about Nibbana, Raja Sutta, and Udana Pali. According to Raja Sutta, Raja Sutta is just read. Only the main words are mentioned here. Atako Bhagava Itamata Vijaitava Tayan Vilayan Ima Udana Udanesi. At the time, realizing that matter, the great teacher uttered the expressions or emotion, this expressions or emotion at that time. Tayam vilayam. Vila means time. Okay. The Lord Buddha uttered this expression of emotion, thinking about Nibbana. The Buddha compared the happiness in Nibbana with the other happiness. How Nibbana is happiness? The Buddha compared comparison clarifying the meaning. What we experience, what we not experience, we should compare. What we experience, we know directly. What we not experience, we don't know. So comparing these two, the Buddha, three happiness, referring to three happiness. So what is the best one? But the Buddha never keep it the reason. Why? What is the reason? You should read this, the Buddha's utterance. Yancha kama sukhan loki yanchita diviya sukha tanakaya sukha siti kalan nekhanti solase. So the meaning is very clear, but for those who learn Pali, who knows Pali, for them, the meaning is very clear. But who have no knowledge of Pali, is maybe not clear the meaning. Kamasukha. Yancha kamasukha loki. Loki means in the wall. In the wall means entire wall. Everywhere in the wall. Loki in the wall. Yancha kamasukha. Yang kamasukha. Kamasukha means everybody experience. Whatever the happiness associated with the sense pleasure. Kama means sense pleasure. We experience kama. What is kama? Sense of pleasure, desirable. Kama means to be desired, the object to be desired. What are they? desirable visible object, what we see with our eye. Most of people enjoy seeing beautiful things. They get happiness. This happiness is kamasukha. Kamasukha. We enjoy the sound, sweet sound. Hearing sweet sound. The sound is, desirable sound is a sense of pleasure. We get happiness such a regarding to such a sense of pleasure. Listening sound, many people enjoy. That is called kamasukha, you see. Everybody experiences kamasukha in this world. We get a sweet smell with our nose. Then we entwine that smell. The happiness enjoying the sense of pleasure, that is kamasukha. We taste. We have good taste with our tongue. We enjoy that taste. That is kamasukha. Most people are searching for kamasukha. Every day at breakfast and lunch. Some people dinner, supper. So many tastes. And there are so many cuisines, restaurants, a lot. Because to enjoy. Not only for sustain our life. People eat food not only for sustain our their life. Most people to enjoy. They have a food. The food cooked in their home, they did not, it is not satisfied. Therefore, they went out. Which restaurant is better? Searching for which restaurant is better. Because to enjoy the taste, this is a kamasukha, you see, a kamasukha. Desirable and tangible object, tangibility, what we touch with our bodies. Luxuries, even the clothes we like, which is smooth. Luxurious mattress, luxurious bed, luxurious place. We enjoy with such a tangible object. Happiness appeared with a tangible object. That is a kamasukha. People cannot abandon this kamasukha. Almost entire people are searching for such a kamasukha. This kama, they never satisfy this kamasukha. Happiness or sense of pleasure. The whole life, they not satisfied. After enjoying this kamasukha, something happened. They have to cry, worried about that. It followed suffering. to Kama Sukha. In this life or in this life, so Yanchidan Kama Sukha, the Buddha said, Yanchidan. Whatever happiness associated with sense of pleasure, with the sense of pleasure in this world. This is a kama sukha. Everybody experience not so difficulty to enjoy such a happiness, easy to for all people, according to their standard. Searching for such an enjoyment, they have to suffer, trying to walk, no? Walking, going here and there, shouting each other, making quarreling each other, you see, for sense of pleasure. For enjoyment of sense of pleasure, they quarrel each other. They want to have more, want to have better, therefore they try. A lot of suffering. The Buddha explained about it that if you wish to have information, more information about that, kama sukha, about that, how suffered because of kama sukha? Dukkha khanda sutta of Majjhima Nikaya. Dukkha khanda, mess of suffering. This discourse on mess of suffering. A lot of sufferings happen. People also wish to enjoy such a sense of pleasure, therefore, they have to experience a lot of suffering. Dukkha khanda sutta and Majjhima Nikaya. The Buddha explained, referring to the war. So that is the meaning. Yancha kama sukhan loke in this kama. This is sense of pleasure. And kama sukha means not only human beings, dogs also have such a kama sukha. Not a nice like people. Animals have to enjoy such a kama sukha. According to their standard, all sentient beings have such a kama. This is called kama sukhanika. In Dhammacakka Bodhana, the Buddha advised us not follow such a kama sukha. Kama sukha lika niyoga. Because he know kamo poto chaniko, like that the Buddha explained. Ananta sahito. Not good beneficials. Not good result. Better result, the Buddha said, Anariyo Anatta Sahito. In the first Sama, the Buddha advised us to abandon such a sense of pleasure, such a happiness or sense of pleasure, to enjoy such a sense of pleasure. So, this kama sukha, a lot of suffering, mixed with a lot of suffering. Then this one, yanchita, yancha ita, divya sukha. Whatever this heavenliness, this happiness. So what do you say? Silesha happiness. Divya. Silesha. Divyan Sukha, celestial happiness. Happiness of deity. Happiness of the sensual pleasure of deities. Celestial happiness. Divya. Divya means deity war. The sensual pleasure appeared in deity war, available in deity war. Enjoying such a sensual pleasure, the deities have happiness. This is happiness. It is better than human happiness. In Brahma war, there are also happiness. This happiness is very peaceful. Even that happiness, including the happiness of Brahma. Divya Sukha. Divya means available in the deity war. Happen in deity war. Sukha, happiness. Happiness of Deva, happiness of Brahma. Such a happiness. This happiness of sensual pleasure. This is a kind of happiness. This is also subject to suffering. They also have a lot of problems in deity wars. In deity wars. Even they enjoy the whole life. But sometimes it is not satisfied. It's not satisfied. Therefore, they want to have more and more. That is a suffering. They want to have more and more. In the end, they have to give up. They have to abandon their happy life. At that time, they are suffering. Worry about that. In the end, they worry about that. Even Brahmas, they dislike to pass away. They want to remain forever. It is impossible. In the end, they have unhappiness. Not permanent. Such a happiness is not permanent. Not nature, tavara, not permanent, not steady, steadies. Therefore, yanchita, divya, sukha, the celestial happiness, these two happiness are associated with the sense of pleasure. But the happiness in Brahma war, this is not a sense of pleasure. They enjoy it with the jhana object. Even that, they have to abandon their happiness. This happiness not permanent. It is impermanent. What is impermanent? It is a suffering. So the Buddha said, the best one, Tanakaya Sukha. Tanakaya Sukha. This is cessations of attachment or cessations of craving. Kaya means cessation or extension, extinction. So cessations of suffering. Cessations of craving, cessations of attachment. You should consider this. Kama Sukha is with attachment. Divya Sukha is with attachment. But nirvana sukha is without attachment. Tanakaya sukha, the state where the sensations are craving. No dana at all. This enjoyment means without dana, without craving. Tanakaya sukha. What is tanakaya sukha? Tanakaya sukha is a nirvana. Tanakaya means where dana ceased. In nirvana stage, dana ceased. By miso radha mekha. By miso radha mekha. The fourth path knowledge. The fourth path knowledge, radha mekha. Through radha mekha, dana ceased, totally ceased. So, tanakaya, this was referring to Radha Mega, Radha Phala, Nirvana. In this case, tanakaya means where their craving ceases or attachment ceases. That is referring to Nirvana. In Nirvana stage, there is no craving. Which is ceased, by which dana ceased, radha mekha. By radha mekha, dana ceased. Radha mekha, when radha mekha ceased dana, cut off dana, or eradicated dana, this Radha Mega have the object of Nirvana. Depending on Nirvana object, Radha Mega make craving ceased, attachment ceased. Radha Mega eradicated craving or attachment with the object of Nirvana. Without the object of Nirvana, Radha Mega cannot arise. Aramana Pachyo, you see. 24 conditions in Patana. Aramana Pachyo. Nirvana is Nirvana supporting condition to as a object condition to Radha Mega. Depending on Nirvana, Radha Mega eradicated attachment. Otherwise, Radha Mega cannot arise without the help of Nirvana. Not any kind of mind can arise without the object. All minds are depending on its object. According to Bhidhamma test, there is not any other mind which can arise without the object. Therefore, Aramana Pachyaya, so wide. Even Bhavanga Chaitas, life continent, we are sleeping, deep sleep. Even the Bhavanga Chaita have, it is an object. Without the object, Bhavanga mind cannot arise within us. It is an object is kamma or kamma nimitta or gati nimitta. It's perceived just before death. According to Bhidhamma, we should understand. But we have not a new object. The form, depending on former object, Bhavanga arises. The whole night sleep, the whole night Bhavanga object arises with it is Bhavanga Chaita arises with it is object. Without the object, not any kind of mind arises. That is Abhidhamma. according to Bhidhama. Here also Mekha Chaitas, or path consciousness, or type of path consciousness, without Nirvana object, they cannot arise. Therefore, here Tanakkaya, Tanakkaya Sukha. In other places we can say the happiness of path consciousness, the happiness associated with path consciousness, or the fourth path consciousness. Then the fourth fruition consciousness, with the fourth fruition consciousness. But in that case, it is referring to Nirvana. Therefore, the Nekhayas, where their attachment ceased, that is Nirvana. The happiness in Nirvana, happiness in Nirvana, Tanakkaya Sukha, happiness associated with the destruction of craving. When the Buddha attained enlightenment, just after attainment of his attainment, the Buddha uttered expression of emotion. Tananang kaya machaka. You see, anega jati sansaran sandavisa anevi. In that verse, the Buddha said, Tananang kaya machaka. Tananang kaya means cessations of attachment, cessations of craving. What he obtained, he obtained the state where craving ceased. Such a state. As long as craving remained, it will create life. As long as attachment, it will create life. But most people think God creates everything. If you blame, no? So God is not lucky because of he created better people. Therefore, he should be blamed. Why God created better people? Terrorists in this world. He must create only good people. If he created only good people, God must be praised. A lot of better people appeared. So it should be plain. Actually, God is not to be blamed, because people just think God create. Just think. They assumed actually not God create. Craving, attachments create. If you wish to blame, you must blame craving. Where is the craving? Within you. You must blame yourself. Not the other people. Not the other beings. I am so bad because I have a craving. I have to suffer because of my craving. I was born as a human being, faced too many problems. Why I am born here? Because of my craving, my attachment. So we should blame only our craving. Therefore the Buddha said, Tananang kaya machaka. The Buddha never blamed any other people. He blamed mental defilements. Mental defilements create everything. Therefore, we have to try to remove, to eradicate mental defilements. So, tanakaya sukhatsa. Tanakaya sukhatsa ita. Iti. Tanakaya sukhaseti. Iti means referring to those happiness. Happiness of sense of pleasure, happiness arise and happiness, silesha, happiness. Those happiness. Kama sukha and diviya sukha. Kama sukha and diviya sukha. Those happiness. These happiness. Kala nakati solasa. Kala means solasa. Solasa means 60. Kala means 60 part. 60 part. That is regarding to the moon. Moon has 60 part. 60 part. To be full moon, 60 days necessary. Now it is only 50 days. Kala means a part of moon. You see, that is according to human world, we see when the waxing days, we saw the moon and the sky, very small crescent, you see. After that, it's bigger and bigger, bigger and bigger. And full moon day, it is the circles, full moon. But actually, 50 days, not full of kala. Kala means a part of moon. This is according to the Abhidhana Patipikas. Kala solas mo bhago. Kala solas mo bhago. The word kala is referring to the sixth part of the moon. Slowly, slowly, moon becomes full. The full moon day, after full moon day, new moon day, after full moon day, 60 days. Is full of that. The moon, all parts are full. Completed. Class completed on that day. Accordingly, it here kala nakati solase. So, it's wish to say, referring to compare these tanakaya sukha, the other sukhas are not worth. The other two sukhas are not worth the 60 traction of the happiness associated with destruction of craving. One, two, three. Their value is so lack, referring to tanakaya sukha. Kama sukha is not value. One part among 60 parts. Very little one to say. No? But not say, not happiness. The Buddha say that is also happiness. But compared to the Nakaya Sukha, they are useless. They are useless. One to say. So, the Nakaya Sukha Satan. Kala negative solace. These two happiness are not worth the 60th fraction, 60th fraction, 60 part. of that happiness associated with the destruction of craving, or cessations of craving. Cessations of craving, more beliefs, want to say. Why? What is your opinion? The Buddha not give the reason why Tanakaya Sutta is better than the other happiness. Tanakaya, happiness or cessation. Because of, you see, if you drink sea water, what it will be?
More thirsty.
You see. Kamasukha, more thirsty. Divyadaka, more thirsty. Non-stop. The more you taste it, the more you have a thirst. The more you have, the more you drink, the more you thirst. Not satisfied. Because of craving. When craving ceased, no thirst at all. All sufferings ceased. Therefore, the Buddha says, Tanakaya Sukha Setan Kalan Nagati Solase. So we are searching for Tanakaya Sukha. By eradicating, by giving up the happiness or sense of pleasure or celestial happiness. The happiness we enjoy, we experience in this world. How to search for the cessations of craving, happiness of cessations of suffering? That is vipassana. The way is sila, started with the sila. Silam, sasana, sa'adi. In the Buddha's teaching, sila is a starting point. Without a sila, cannot succeed. Sila is important. For what? Sila lead to samadhi. Without a sila, to have samadhi is very, very difficult. Mind always wavering, wandering about from object to object. Without a sila, samadhi is difficult to have. Therefore, sila is important to have a samadhi. Without a samadhi, yathabhuta jnana, seeing, knowing and seeing things as they really are, is impossible. Only with the samadhi is possible. Therefore, sila, samadhi, panya, we must establish these three practices. Eightfold Noble Path or Majjhima Patibhara, Middle Way, is composed of these three practices, sila, samadhi, panya. Not of other things, only of these Eightfold Noble Path. Sila, samadhi, panya. That is the way. You know, sila, if we have a sila, pure sila, purification of morality, if we purify in a sila, we never worry about it. It is a goal, free from worry, avipati sara, free from worry. Being free from worry, lead to rejoice, pamocha. Rejoice, Pamoja lead to enjoy, pity, joy, pity. Pity lead to tranquility, pasati. Tranquility, pasati lead to happiness or bliss, sukha. Sukha. Sukha lead to samadhi, concentration, mental concentration. So, sila is important. Sila lead to up to concentration. Then concentration lead to yathābhūta, jñāna, dasana. Knowing and seeing things as they really are. Yathābhūta, jñāna, dasana. Yathābhūta jñāna dasana so lead to nibbīdā jñāna. Did not find enjoyable and fabricate. No attachment. Nibbīdā so lead to virāga. Free from attachment. This is Mecca. Virāga vimocchati. When there is no more attachment, his mind is free from attachment. That is final liberation. Mentally final liberation. Physically not yet. Physically after death. Mentally, first mentally freedom. First mentally freedom. Second, physically freedom. So tanakaya sukhasa. According to this way, we must practice. The path to cessation of craving is a vipassana or a Eightfold Noble Path. This is according to Raja Sutta. Okay. The Buddha's words is very brief, but the meaning is very wide. The meaning is very deep and wide. Then, Mahamoggallana Sutta. According to Mahamoggallana Sutta. Atakho bhagava itamattam vijetava tayam vilayam ima udana udanesi. Atakho then bhagava kriticha. Vidaitavas, realizing, knowing, it matter, this matter. Knowing, then knowing or realizing this matter, the great teacher. Udana, ima udana, udanes, uttered this expression or emotion at that time. So, only Buddha's words are noted here. Sati kaya gata upatita. Chasu pasayadanesu sanvudo. Satatam bhikkhu samahito janya nirvana matano. This is the path to nirvana explained. Not about nirvana, the path to nirvana. How to attain nirvana? How to attain nirvana? This is the same way, you see. Like ekayana mekha. Ekayana bhikkhu ayam mekho. This way is a single way. Not the other way, only way. The same. Mahasadivadana sutta completed. So the path to nirvana, explained. According to meditation, some of meditation practice, how to meditate, sati kaya kata upatita. Mindfulness, with the mindfulness dispatched to the body present, translation. Kaya kata sati upatita means mindfulness should established on the body. This is a kaya kata sati. Always mindfulness. You see, our mind is not stay with us. Our mind is not stay with us, not remain with us. It's always wandering about. Here and there, the object of the sensory object, sound, smell, taste, like that, going out, not to remain in the body. Therefore, our mindfulness must be on the body. Kaya nubasana, kaya gata tati. Sati upatita. Mindfulness established on the body, own body. What is that? It is a kaya gata sati meditation method or kaya nupasana meditation method. If you wish to read, you can read a kaya gata sati sutta, directly by the Buddha. Kaya gata sati sutta or Majjhima Nikaya. There are a lot of informations you should read. Majjhima Nikaya, Kaya Gata Sati Sutta. How to follow, how to practice Kaya Gata Sati meditation. Another, Visuddhimagas also have in detail. Visuddhimagas with the explanation. The path of purification or the path of purity is with the translations or English, German, maybe any other languages. What about the Chinese? What about the other languages? In Myanmar language, Burmese language is also have Visuddhimagga translated into Myanmar. Any languages. Originally Pali language. Originally it is in Pali. So tati sati kaya gata upatita me referring to kaya gata sati meditation or kaya nupasana meditation. And Mahasatipatthana Sutta kaya nupasana. Even anapana is a kaya gata sati. Kaya nupasana, kaya gata sati, even anapana. Don't think this meditation method is not a meditation center. The technique meditation center's advice you is this included this meditation. This is the only way, you see. Only way. So sati kaya gata upatita. The translation with the mindfulness dispatched to body present, he said. Actually, kaya kata means remaining kaya. The sati, mindfulness which remain in the kaya is established, one to say. So our mindfulness must be the body. Anyway, some people also meditate, the heart beats also. Some people also meditate the sensation, the whole body, from head to the foot also. Many ways, you see. But we must keep our mindfulness in the body. Actually, if you want to follow the Buddha's exact words, you should read Kaya Gata Sati Sutta. Kagada Sati Sauta or Machiva Nikaya. Kesa Loma Nakada Data Cho, this also Kagada Sati. You should know the buying Kesa. You have a lot of Kesa. No need to buy. No need to spend your money, meditation. So easy. What do you have, you can meditate on it. Nothing cost. Free from charge, you see. Kesaloma nakaranda tacho, what we have, we should meditate with mindfulness. This is kagata sati. Pritim prita, this is also kagata sati. Because it's concerning with the bodies. So kagata sati. Kaya nupasana, kagata sati. Contemplation of the body. Contemplation of the body, kaya nupasana. Mindfulness in the body, kāyagata sati. So the Buddha said, sati kāyagata upatthita. You must try to establish your mindfulness on your body. Don't let your mind out. Don't let your mind, the object which is out. Chasu pasayadanesu sanghuto. Pasayadanas. What is pasayadana? You see? Six sense doors. Six sense doors. Here, contacts. Six contacts. Visual object contact to sensitive eye. Sound contact to ear, sensitive ear. Smell contact to the nose, sensitive nose. Taste contact to the tongue. Tangible objects contact to the body. The other objects contact to mind. So, through pasa. Mind contact with the object. Interne mind contact with the external object. That is very simple. Every day, you see things, visual object with your eye. You hear sound with your ear. You get a smell with your nose. You taste with your tongue. You touch the tangible object with the body. You have an idea with the other object. So all external objects are contact to your mind. Such a contact, you must restrain. Sanghuto. You must restrain. Be careful. That is, sati remain in the body means sati remain. Sati must be watchful. When external object contact your eye, be careful about that. What did the object contact? The mindfulness is important. Sanghuta. Sanghuta means restraint. Restraint. Sanghuta, samvara. No, restraint. Sanghuta, samvara. Not a let. What do you restrain? You must watch for this. See on the object. Don't let craving arise towards it. Don't let hatred arise towards that object. That is a restraint. Don't close to your eye. No need to close. I will see what is it. Visual object. I is to see. I is for seeing. Otherwise, I will be useless. You have an eye. You can see whatever visual object. But you must control. What is that? You must control only craving, attachment to the object. Attachment to the object, hatred to the object, delusion regarding to the object. That is a restraint. So the Buddha says, Sasu, Chasu, Pasayatane, Su, Sanwudo. 6 doors must be careful. You must watch 6 doors. Watchful. You must be watchful 6 doors with mindfulness. That is the meaning. Okay. A few minutes break. Okay. But only 10 minutes.